Ciao, everyone. It's your favorite Italian-American linguist here with a very special episode in our series, Cosa Dici. Today, we're taking a break from our regularly scheduled programming to give you a mini lesson on the linguistic history of Italy. In Italy, there are many, many languages spoken. There's the standard Italian that you learn in school, but there are also hundreds of other regional languages, or regional vernaculars, which we mistakenly label dialects. These regional languages, or vernaculars, aren't dialects because they aren't derived from standard Italian. And in fact, they existed before there was standardization of language in Italy. Before its unification in 1861, Italy was a very fractured state, with different areas governed by different populations, and over time, many different forms of contact between cultures gave birth to these regional languages. It wasn't until the 14th century that a Florentine variety of Tuscan actually gained prestige. And this was because Le Tre Corone, or the Three Crowns, Dante, Boccaccio, and Petrarca, were from Tuscany and wrote in their regional language, which then gained popularity and was considered superior to all other regional languages. Over time, the other dialects lost their prestige and became inferior. In fact, if you chose to speak in your dialect, you were considered uneducated. With the unification of Italy in 1861 came the standardization of the language. This Tuscan dialect became the standard and was disseminated across all of Italy through different means, mass media, the military, and in schools. In the US, we have an interesting form of exposure to the Italian dialects through Italian Americans. When there was a big wave of immigration from southern Italy to the US, it was during the time of the standardization of Italian. And therefore, those who immigrated didn't really have that same exposure to the standard as all of those who remained in Italy. And therefore, they brought over their regional languages instead of standard Italian. This is why words like agita and capisce and all the other words that we love are actually derived from dialectal, or these regional languages, and not the standard Italian. Sadly, in Italy, these regional languages are slowly disappearing as younger generations are only being exposed to standard Italian. Thus, we really need to appreciate the presence of these regional languages here in the United States and the fact that they gave birth to such an important culture here in America. Let us know in the comments below if you're interested in hearing more about these regional languages, and maybe we'll bring in some samples to show you just how different they really are. See you next week for another episode of Cosa Dici. Ciao! What are you saying?